Hello friends, this is Priyanka. Today we are going to solve a problem on hydrostatic forces on surfaces. So in this video, we are going to solve a problem about force due to water pressure on lock gates. So first, I will read what is the given problem. Each gate of lock is 6 meter high and is supported by two hinges placed on the top and bottom of the gate. When the gates are closed, they make an angle of 120 degree. The width of lock is 5 meter. If the water levels are 4 meter and 2 meter on the upstream and downstream sides respectively, determine the magnitudes of the forces on the hinges due to water pressure. So this was the given problem. We will first understand the diagram as per the given data. Now the height of this lock gate is given 6 meter. So we will draw here the front view for this lock gate. So when we observe this lock gate from the front, we can observe it in the form of edge. So here this is the lock gate having height of 6 meter. Then on upstream side, what is the level of water? That is 4 meter height. So we have to show that, and on the downstream side there is the level of water up to 2 meter height, and at the top and bottom there is the hinge. Now again we will move for the top view. So when we observe this lock gate from the top, here the angle between two lock gates, that is here, is 120 degree that we have to show. So if we observe this AB and BC, so angle in between this AB and BC is 120 degree. And what is the width of this lock gate? So total width, that is 5 meter, and it is given. So in this way, as per the given data, we have to construct this lock gate, that is the front view as well as top view. Now we will move for the given data. So it is given that height of the lock 6 meter, then width of the lock. So here is width of the lock 5 meter, then width of each lock gate. So width of each lock gate, here is the AB and here is the BC. So we will say this length of AB, that is L. So how to calculate this L? So for that again we have to make here one construction. So from this point B, I will draw here one vertical line. So in the form of dash, I will draw. So this is the center line passing through this AB and BC. So I will say this point of intersection will be point D. Now this, because of the center line, this total angle 120 degree divided into two parts. So what is here the angle? Angle is 60 degree. So this line is perpendicular. So here the angle is 90 degree. So what is the remaining angle? So here remaining angle is 30 degree. Now we have to find out what is the length of this AB. That means we will say here this will be L. So how to find out? So here total width is given 5 meter and this is the center line. So we will say that this height A to D is 5 by 2, that is 2.5 meter. So I will write here AD is equal to 2.5 meter. So how to find out this AB length? So we know that cos of 30. Cos 30 means what? So cos of 30 is equal to AD divided by AB. So now we want to know what is this AB. So we can write here L, that is equal to AB, which is equal to AD by cos of 30. So AD, that is equal to 2.5, and cos of 30. So when we calculate this, we will get the answer 2.887 meters. So this is the length of AB, which is equal to BC. So we can write this. Now again, if we observe, this is the lock, that is this is the horizontal line. Now again we will move for the calculation of angle of inclination with normal to this lock. So first we have to draw one normal line, that is one perpendicular line to this lock. So I will draw here one line in the form of dash. So this is the angle theta that we have to calculate. So how to calculate? Now if we observe, here is the theta angle, this is the normal, and here is the lock, that is this horizontal line in between these two gates is lock. So how to calculate this angle theta. Now if we observe, I will draw here one construction line, that is one vertical line. So what is happening? On this vertical line, on one side, if we observe, this total angle is 180 degree. So 180 minus 120, that is equal to, here is also angle theta, and here the also will be same angle theta, because this is both the gates having same inclination. So 180 minus 120 divided by 2, which is equal to this theta. So we have to calculate this. So what is the theta? So theta is equal to 30 degree. So we will get this angle of inclination for this log gate. Then we will move for the calculation of force due to water pressure on upstream side. So for that we have to draw three-dimensional diagram. So here is the three-dimensional diagram for this log gate. Now these are the points A, B, C. So at point B there is the log. Now if we observe, this AB means this length L, and which is equal to 2.887, and here is the height. So I will say here EF. So I will say here two letters, that is A to E. So what is this height A to E? That we can show here. I will show here. Here suppose there is the point A, then the bottom point will be E. So this height is 6 meters, that is given. Now for the upstream side, that is at this side which is having the level of water for 4 meter height, we will find out what is the force due to water pressure on the gate. So now I will, if I draw here the, then this total height is 6, then here is the free surface of water and here is the water. That is, the up to this level the gate is in contact with water. So what is the formula to calculate this force? That is rho g a into h bar. But for upstream side we will use here the suffix 1. That means for the force we will use here F1, and what is the formula? Rho g a1 h1 bar. So we have to write this. Now what is the height of this water? That is, we will say capital H1 is equal to 4 meter, that we have to write. So what is the rho? That is density of water 1000, g 9.81. Now A1, so area in contact with water, that we have to calculate. So if we observe, this is the rectangular shape. That is, up to this level we have to find out what is the area. So what is the height? Height is 4 meter. And what is the length? Length of this AB, that is equal to 2.887. So we have to write this as an area. And what is the H1 bar? So H1 bar is the distance of the center of gravity from the free surface of water. So here at this middle point, that is, here is the free surface of water is 4 meter height. So we have to take here the middle point, that is 4 divided by 2. So this 4 divided by 2, that is at this middle point there is the center of gravity point. So we have to calculate this. So what is the answer here? 226,571 Newton. So this is the force F1. Now again we can say that force F1 will be at a distance of H1 by 3. So where this force F1 is getting located? So now suppose we have to show the location for this force F1, that means we can say center of pressure. So here I will say point P1 will be the center of pressure. So where is the location? That is this whole height H1 divided by 3 from the bottom. So here H1 divided by 3 for the bottom, that is equal to 1.33 meter from the bottom. So here the force F1 will act, and we have to show this, that is 1.33. So we have to show here. Now in the same way we have to calculate what is the force F2 and where is the location of this force F2. So it is same formula that we have to use. So here is for downstream side, we will use here as a suffix 2. So F2 is equal to rho g A2 H2 bar. So now rho g we know, what is A2? That is area. So again I will draw here. Here the water level is for the 2 meter height. So this is the height of water level from this downstream side, and what is the width? Width is L, that is equal to 2.887. So that will be area of rectangular shape 2 multiplied by 2.887. And what is the H2 bar? So H2 bar is here we have to take the center of gravity point. That is the distance of the center of gravity point from the free surface of water. So here 2 divided by 2, that is 1. So if we calculate this, we will get the answer 56,643 newton. Now again we have to find out what is the center of pressure, that means what is the location for this force F2. So how to calculate this? Again same formula, that is H2, this total height H2 divided by 3, and that will be distance from the bottom. So H2 divided by 3, that means 2 divided by 3, which is equal to 0.67 meter. So again we can show here the location of force F2. So here is the F2, and we have to show here the distance, that is 0.67 meter from the bottom. Now we will calculate what is the resultant force due to this upstream and downstream side on this gate AB due to water. So that is F. So we have to show this. So how to show this? We will show this in this diagram. So this force F is always in perpendicular direction to the inclination of gate. So I will show here with perpendicular line. So here will be the force F. So how to calculate this force F? So if we observe the direction of F1 and F2, the both directions are in opposite direction. So we will say that F is equal to F1 minus F2. So F1 is maximum. So when we calculate this, we will get the answer, that is 169,928 newton. Now again, if we observe, we have to find out what is the location for this resultant force F. So we will consider the location for this resultant force F will be at a distance x from the bottom. Because why only bottom? Because we know the distance of this F1 and F2 from this bottom. So again we will consider the force F will be at a distance of x from the bottom. So we will take the moments of this F1, F2 and force F about this bottom hinge. So here there are two hinges, that at point A and E. So at point E, that is at bottom hinge, we will take the moments. So we know that F is equal to F1 minus F2. So when we take the moment, that is we have to multiply with this perpendicular distance from this hinge. So here is the perpendicular distance. So x, that is unknown. So we will write here F multiplied by x, which is equal to, now this F1 multiplied by this perpendicular distance, that is 1.33, minus F2 multiplied by this perpendicular distance, that is 0.67. So here is only one unknown term, that is x, because F, F1 and F2 are known. So when we put value, we will get x is equal to 1.55 meter. So this x value, that is force F, is located at a distance of 1.55 meter from the bottom. Then we know formula P is equal to F by 2 sin theta, that is the formula. Then what is this P? So P is the reaction at common contact surface of two gates. So where is the common contact surface? So this horizontal line that I have shown here with this red marker, that is the common contact surface of the two gates and acting perpendicular to the contact surface. So we have to draw here one line that is perpendicular to this contact surface. So I am drawing here with the help of this dashed line. So this is the line that is perpendicular to this common contact surface. So this is, along this line there is the reaction, that is P, that we have to show. So I will show this with the arrow, and here is the P. So we know that this angle between this inclined gate and this reaction P is theta, and that we have already calculated this angle theta. So theta is equal to 30 degree that we have to put. Then F, we know what is the value of F. So we have to put here. Then what is the calculated value of P? So P is equal to 1,69,928. Now we will consider R is equal to the action at the top and bottom hinge. So we will consider the notation is R, and R is equal to P. So if we consider this R is equal to P, then what is the value of R? That is 1,69,928 Newton. So now I will show here in this diagram, at the top hinge there is the reaction for the top hinge, that is RT, and the reaction at the bottom hinge we will say RB. Now we have to show, so how to show this reaction R in this diagram. So I will show here, this is the reaction at the hinge, so we have to show in this way, that is the reaction R. Now what is the location for this reaction R? So for where the location of this resultant force F, that is 1.55 meter from the bottom, and at the same location we have to show here the reaction, that is the here the reaction for this top and bottom hinge. This is the resultant for this RT and RB, and we have to show this R, and again I will show the distance also, that is 1.55 meter. So this is the diagram. So we know that what is R. So R is equal to RT plus RB. So again we will take the moments about this bottom hinge. So when we take moment, so moment means what? The moment means force multiplied by perpendicular distance. So in this formula only, that is RT plus RB is equal to R, we have to just multiply with perpendicular distance with this bottom hinge. So hinge is there, here at the bottom and at the top. So what is the distance of RT up from this bottom hinge? So this total height is 6 meters. So we have to multiply with 6. So RT multiplied by 6 plus RB. So RB at the bottom hinge. So here is 0 distance, which is equal to R. So R is the from the bottom hinge, the distance is 1.55. So R multiplied by 1.55. So what is the value of RT? So RT is equal to 43,898 Newton. And what is the value of RB? So we have to put this value of RT in this formula, that is RT plus RB, which is equal to R. So R is known, that is R is equal to P. So what is the value of RB here? That is 1,26,030 Newton.